shark has pretty teeth, dear, and he shows them a pearly white. Just a jackknife has Mac Heat, dear, and he keeps it out of sight. When the shark bites with his teeth, dear, scarlet billows start to spread. Fancy gloves, though, where's Mac Heat, dear? So there's not a trace of red. On the sidewalk, Sunday morning, lies a body oozing life. Someone sneaking around the corner. Is this someone? Mac knife from a tugboat by the river. A cement bag's drooping down. Yes, the cement's just for the weight, dear. Bet you Mac Heat's back in town. Look a year, Louis Miller disappeared, dear, after drawing out his cash. And Mac Heat spends like a sailor. Did our boy do something rash? Sookie Tawdry, Jenny Diver, Lottie Lanier, Sweet Lucy Brown. Oh, the line forms on the right, dears. Now that Mac Heat's back in town.
Take it, Satch.
Now, where's the prayer? The what? Powder. There.
This one.
You can hold that one up for
you.
Thank you.
Well, you can fool me. This is how not to do me.
Is this?
What comes after the powder?
Apparently not.
The eyes.
The eyes.
No, I think you should give it.
Sorry, I get carried away every time I see a camera.
Where's your face? You're on the punch,
buddy. Do that again.
Yes.
Even though I'm in half your
shirt. Very convincing.
Thanks, Joel.
Come back in 5 minutes, you'll have the full monty.
Well, that's yeah, it looks like it.
What do you think? Do you think it'll fit in?
So, everybody, this is Jen, yes. My friend. Yeah. Just
hi, Jen.
Hi, Jen. Turn around, turn the back.
Hi. My name's Faye.
Faye.
Don't be thrilled to be scared.
Yeah. You know, I always get you in the last scene.
I did explain to him. Did I tell you for
a minute? Oh, yes, yeah. No, just watch the finger.
Put your hand on the under and hand it on the rocks.
I think I'm going to have to put music in this when background.
Was this was 2 weeks ago, wasn't it?
Neither were the voices.
When he first came home.
Huh?
When he first came home.
Yeah, the first week he was here.
Is he down at the moment?
No.
Is he down?
Oh,
really?
Yeah. Okay, well, see you later. Bye.
Cheerio.
Bye.
Bye.
Hello.
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 Hello, camera. How are you?
Just to see how people react to a camera. Okay, see you later.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. And here's Oliver.
Hiding.
I must get everybody in here. And Penny and Pat.
That's right.
That's a nice house. Are they for the thing?
Definitely not.
Why not?
Anyway, folks, enjoy your thing.
I won't give you my lipstick.
No, why not? I mean, it's actually nice. You know, 50 and I still end up with lipstick all over. It could be worse.
Yeah, why?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay, I'll see you folks just now before we all
have a good time.
Go up. Same to you.
Okay.
If you need doing in between.
Yes, this is me. Old spiking.
If you need doing in between
old
times,
spiky spanking? Oh, spiky.
Okay, I'll just give you a shout.
Okay. I can do it quick.
I'm just thinking for my
shirt. No, stop. I hate this guy.
looking for other ones.
Song in Welsh or in English?
Well, I'm sorry, in
out this way a bit more, would you? You're not in need of the music, are you?
No.
No, John. Now, just try placing your weight equally on both your feet, you see? Legs slightly apart, you see? That's it, a little bit more. Now, can you feel yourself balanced, can you?
Yes.
You see, singing is a great deal to do with balance, Mr. Jones, balance, you see? I mean, you can't sing on one leg now, can you? I mean, you feel unbalanced.
Yes.
Right, then, shoulders back then, man, shoulders right back. That's better, that's better. Now, Mr. Jones, before you start this time, I want you for a moment, if you were to breathe like this, you see? In through the nose and out through the mouth. And again, as deep as you can, that's it. In through the nose and out through... No, there's no one to hyperventilate. Breathe normally, that's all. Now, can you feel all that air, can you?
Yes.
In your passages, can you feel it rushing along your passages?
Yes.
Blowing the cobwebs of your passages?
Yes.
Good. Now you look like a real singer, Mr. Jones. From the top, please, Miss Ames. From the top. Let it flow out of you, Mr. Jones. Let it flow. It's a song that sings itself. Like a river.
Page 30, when you will that? Next June?
All right, all right. Was that over? okay? It's Mars, take Mars.
Riveting. Can't wait to find out who done it. Come on, let's go and fix it.
Just looking at that last scene, I think you might find it a benefit from a bit of gesture.
Yes, thank you, Jarvis, I'm sure.
Just they used to use your arms a lot in those days, you know.
Yes, well, I'll be stuffing it full of gestures at a later stage, Jarvis. Don't worry, you won't see that stage for our movements.
Oh, well, you don't mind me saying.
Oh, not at all, Jarvis. It's just that, you know, Ted, I mean, it takes a month or two just to get any pointing to that. You know, Ted.
You don't mind me coming up with the odd idea from time to time?
At all, Jarvis. Feel free. Any time. You know, you really must do a production yourself sometime. And then I can come along and buddy yours if you interfere in your process. The road to the police, sir. He's a cantankerous old bastard, the chap who runs it, but it's the best pint for 30 miles. Splendid. Ah, Bridget, you'll switch on, will you?
Yeah.
Bridget's our stage manager, also playing Jenny Diver. We couldn't function at all without Bridget. She's the one who keeps us all sane, Mr. Jones.
Good for you. I'm just going over the road to brain this cantankerous old publican now. I'll see you over there, perhaps.
You certainly will. Bridget's his daughter.
I've been picking up from where we left off, Deckard.
Yes, my love, we'll carry straight on.
Right, so from the bottom of page one, then.
Now, please, don't you start, there's a dear. Fit then, are you, Mr. Jones?
Yes.
Right, well, away we go.
Scotty, are you?
No.
They're the only ones that do that, you know. whiskey, chum. Whiskey, beer, whiskey, beer. That's what they do it. Scotty, right?
No, no, I...
You can always tell them. You can always tell them.
I didn't understand that at all.
Don't worry, he's completely mad.
Ah.
Quite harmless, though.
Glad to hear it.
No, it's her you've got to watch. Oh, I think this means we're going. Good night, then.
Good night.
I do excuse us. Some nights he can hardly contain himself.
Night. Night.
Hey, Jimmy! Jimmy!
Me?
Yes, you. Do you want another wee one in there?
Oh, no thanks, it's a
joke. Another wee one for our friend from across the border.
Conscious, but he's not right.
Very wrong.
He's a
find you do have a problem, just give me a ring at home.
Oh, thank you,
Debra. I'll be back there in about 10 minutes, so good night.
I hope you sleep well all through the night.
Yes, thank you.
Yes.
An effortlessly witty woman, indeed, I think you'll find. Listen, we still haven't settled this casting business, have we? I think we ought to do that now, don't you?
Well, yes, that'd be nice. Give me so much for getting on with
it. Well, are you two going, or do I have to throw you out as well?
No, we're going, Bridget. It's all right, all right. Listen, have you got your car with you by any chance?
Yes, it's just around the corner.
Oh, look, my place is only a couple of streets away. I could give you a script and a cup of cocoa. Well, that suits you.
Yes, then.
Right, off we go. Me. I think he's been left there as a hint by someone this evening. I'll put the kettle on. Hold me a second. If you're cold at all, put the fire on. Personally, I think it's pretty warm, don't you? Wait there. By the way, I never asked you, tea, coffee, or cocoa?
Tea.
No problem. Now, I hear you ran into the wife.
Well...
Or rather, she ran into you.
Yes, that's more like it.
Yes, well, she's, you know, women.
Yes.
Never like being taken by surprise, do they? Not unless they know what it is in advance. I'd like to surprise you for your birthday, darling. What would you like? Now, this casting business, I have a feeling, an instinctive feeling on my bones, and I'm not often wrong. Sometimes, but not often, that you'd make a pretty good Crookfin Jack. You fancy that, do you? Having a crack at Crookfin Jack?
Oh, yes, it sounds pretty interesting.
Yes, I'll be honest, it's not a vast part. Do you know the Beggar's Opera at all?
No, it's not one of them.
No, well, as I say, it's not a vast part, but he does feature. In fact, he features pretty strongly, really, for the sort of size of part he is. I mean, in terms of speeches, well, let me see. Yes, well, he's got probably, just a one-line act, too, but it's the sort of character, you know, that at the end of an evening, an audience tends to remember quite graphically.
Oh, perhaps that's because of his finger.
What? No, you see, the play is full of these marvellous characters. I mean, there are the Highwayman, Crookfinger, Jack, Nimmy Ned, Ben Budge, Jemmy Twitcher, Matter the Lint. Yes, there was the possibility of that character, but my feeling as director is that Matter the Lint prove a little too adventurous for you first time round.
Oh, of course.
That is anyway a reflection.
No, please. I'll be glad to write
you. Well, I'm giving that particular part to Dr. Packer, who has, to be fair, a great deal of experience. Still, I'm sure it will only be the first of many for you and us, hopefully.
I hope so, too.
Good. Do you want to take this one, then?
Oh, thank you very much.
You'll find he comes on page 33. There we are. And then he goes off again on page 35. But I'm seriously thinking about bringing him back on again in Act 3, but that's to be confirmed.
Oh, splendid, thank you very much.
Good. Well, it's quite a departure for Palos, this year.
Palos?
The Pen and Amateur Light Operatic Society.
Oh, sorry.
Yes, I had a lot of opposition in against this one, I can tell you, in committee. I mean, all the old diehards there. You know, original walk-ons in Chu Chin Chow, you know the sort. But, you know, I'm absolutely convinced that this show first produced, when was it? 1728 is as entertaining and as vital and as relevant as it was there. I mean,
Zoe Dory, Dolly Trull, Mrs. Vixen. I mean, those are the whores and pimps of the town. You can almost see their faces in their names, can't you? Polly Peachum. That tells you all you want to know about her, doesn't it? What an age, eh? What an age. Well, I mean, compared to our own.
Oh, of course. I mean, they didn't have any...
Well, look at us today. Look at us today, Guy. I mean, sexuals, I ask you. I mean, can you imagine Captain McKee furtively purchasing marital aids? I mean, what's happening to us, eh? I mean, what's happening to us? Sorry, I tend to get a little over-enthusiastic occasionally. So I told
you. Not at all. Did you ever consider doing the theatre professionally?
Oh, it's just... Yes, I was in the profession for some years.
Oh, really?
Oh, yes, I've done my bit.
As a producer?
No, I was acting in those days, acting, and a little bit of stage management, you know.
Whereabouts?
Oh, well, all over, really. I mean, a lot of it in my head.
Oh, yes.
Still, that's all water under the bridge now. Respectable solicitor these days. Well, recently. what line are you in, Guy?
Hello. Yes,
this is my wife, Anna.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Dearest, this is Mr. Jones, Guy Jones.
Hello.
Let me over there, shall we?
Yes, it won't mark there. Do sit down, please.
Thank you.
It's cold in here. Heating's off.
Is it? I can't say we've noticed. It's boiling, isn't it? Yes.
Oh, I presume you both wanted cocoa. I saw the tin was out.
No, sorry, no. Guy wanted tea.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
I can make tea.
Oh, no, please.
Well, tea's no trouble.
No, that's fine, really.
Oh. Well, if you're quite sure.
Oh, I'm just as happy as this.
Well, there we are.
Thank you.
Well, I'll leave you to it then.
No, don't go.
You want to talk business?
Oh, no, we've finished. Sit down for a second.
Please.
Well, only if I'm not in the way.
We hardly call it business, can we? Guy's going to be giving us his crook finger, Jack.
Sorry?
Our missing brigand. He's just joined us.
Wonderful.
Do you think you'll make a good highwayman, do you, Hannah? Do you think you'll make a great Jack?
Well, possibly.
Oh, dear, she doesn't sound too convinced, does she, Guy? But doesn't he convince you?
Yes. I just think he looks a bit handsome for a highwayman.
I don't know what you say to that, Guy. I really don't. What do you say to that?
I don't really know.
Maybe we could give him an eye patch.
Yes.
the twins all right, are they?
Yes, they're asleep.
Will he stop coughing?
Yes, I'm ready with the link.
Good. Good.
We have twin girls.
Yes.
Gwyneth, who's got a cold, and the family who's just getting over it. They're just going circles.
Nice names.
Yes, that is the one that I've chosen.
With our help. Everything's Welsh in this house.
Except me, that is.
Except her, that is. She was made in Middlesex.
Oh, really? Middlesex.
Except that he's from Middlesex, then?
No.
Oh.
No, he's from Leeds, aren't you?
Yes.
No, dearest, he hasn't got a wife.
Oh?
No.
No, she died recently.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear, I didn't know that. Accident, was it?
No, not really. It was
deliberate. No, I'm sorry, Guy. I said it. I'm sorry.
It's quite all right.
It's always doing that.
No, she was ill for some time, actually.
Oh, dear. How long's she been
here? Just over a year.
Oh.
It took me some time, obviously, to adjust.
Yes, it would.
Then eventually I decided it was high time I got out and about again, which is why I took the plunge and wrote for David.
David.
Davis.
No, David. David.
David.
David.
Oh, really? It's near enough.
Near enough is not enough.
Bad enough as it is. How do you fancy standing in the dry cleaners trying to pronounce your own surname?
Llewellyn. What could be simpler? Llewellyn.
Yes, I'm with BLM, actually.
Oh, BLM, over on the Western Estate.
That's right.
Oh, the big boys, eh?
They are, I'm not.
What do they do, BLM? I've always meant to ask.
Well, that's a rather difficult question to answer, isn't it, Guy?
Just a bit.
I mean, what do they do? Do they make anything?
Vast profits, mostly, right?
Right.
Well, don't tell me if you don't want to.
No, we're actually a multinational company that's become extremely diversified.
Ah, diversified, dearest. That means they do all sorts
yes,
of
things. I know.
Yes, all right.
I know what diversified is.
Okay.
And so it's a bit difficult to pin down. And certainly it is from my limited viewpoint in a rather small local branch in a rather obscure department called Alternative Forward Costing, in which I'm a very small cog indeed.
I'm impressed anyway.
It's interesting you should work for BLM. It could be quite
a girl.
Oh, I'll go. It could be Ted. Yes, as usual, as usual.
These friends of ours, they have this daughter they absolutely dote over. And of course she just takes terrible advantage of them all the time.
Yes, I met them.
Did you?
Yes.
Yes, she's a real headache for them. She set fire to all of them clothes, you know.
Set fire to them?
Yes. Enid wasn't in them at the time.
No, my wife wasn't able to. She wasn't very strong.
Shame. Do you miss her a lot?
Yes. Yes, I do very much.
That's nice. For her, I mean. Of course, not for you. I'd like to think I've been.
You?
Yes.
Why? You're not,
Oh, no. It's right as rain, I think, as far as I know. Just that I sometimes wonder, I suppose a lot of us probably do, if whether I, you know, died, people would really... Silly, really, isn't it?
I'm sure you'd be missed.
Maybe.
By name, Daphne, and your children?
Yes, possibly the children would. For a few more years, anyway. Don't know about Daphne. Now, he is missed. You see this dog here? Well, every time Daphne's out of the house more than 20 minutes, the girls insist he's brought out, and all their games revolve around this wretched dog. Tea with Daddy Doll, and walks with Daddy Doll, and supper with Daddy Doll, and bed with Daddy Doll. Well, I've stopped them taking it to bed with them now. I did think that was getting too much of a good thing. Of course, Daddy thinks it's terribly funny. Suppose it's quite flattering for him in a way. Trouble is, my family are under the impression there's a female counterpart to this thing that runs around the house after them, only it happens to be me. Hooray for Mummy Doll!
That was Enid. They got home and they found Linda in bed. Yes, that's what I asked, and the answer is no. Fast asleep on her own she was, so false alarm. They still have a daughter, and what's more important, we still have a Lucy Locket. Well, what's been going on in here then? Anything I should know about?
I think it's my bedtime, please.
Oh, heavens, yes, it's late.
No, don't go on my account, I'm a late one myself.
No, it really is.
Well, I'll fetch your coat.
Thank you. Well, thank you very much for your hospitality.
Not much of that. I didn't even drink your cocoa.
Another time, perhaps.
Here we are. Thank you, Mr. Jones. You're
always. Thank you. Well, I hope I'll be seeing you again before too long.
What on earth? You're talking about Annie and me? Why, you'll see her tomorrow night.
Really?
Didn't she tell you she's in the show? She's odd Polly Creature, aren't you?
Oh, I see.
Oh,
a lot better in the mornings, usually. I'll see you tomorrow then.
Good night.
Good night.
Listen, Guy, just a word before you go. This coincidence that you're working for BLM could prove quite opportune. The point is, I'm acting for a client at the moment who was involved in purchasing a couple of acres of wasteland. I mean, it's small stuff, nothing very exciting. Except two reasons. Firstly, the land is slap bang adjoining your apprentice.
Oh, the bit around the back, you mean?
Yes, it's the sports field. Well, it used to be a sports field. And second, although this is only your say, rumour has it that you boys are shortly planning to expand. Any truth in that, do you know?
No, not as far as I know.
Only, of course, if you are, then, of course, the land in question could suddenly be worth quite a bit. Do you follow?
Yes, I do see.
Depending, of course, on how many people get to know about it. I mean, putting it in plainer words, if the chap who's selling it doesn't know, whereas we who are buying it do know, then we could be getting quite a bargain. some arrangement. No doubt.
Oh, no, no need for that, really.
Yes, fair, 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 fair.
Well, yes, I suppose if we really want to be fair, we ought to warn the person who's selling the land.
Oh, no, no, I don't think that's all.
You don't?
No, no, if I did that, I'd be betraying my own client, wouldn't I? And it wouldn't be ethical.
Oh, yes.
No, no, it's up to this other fellow's solicitor to warn him, not me. Anyway, keep your ear to the ground.
Yes, indeed.
And remember, mum's the word.
Rather. Well, good night.
Yes. Thank you very much. Yes, surely, yes. We'll see you tomorrow night. We're really going to get cracking, I can tell you. You won't see that stage for dust.
Thank you.
Better bring your racing skates. Yes, Crookfinger Jack. Yes, well, what about him?
Well, I was wondering if you want him with a finger.
Finger. Something like this, perhaps. Or maybe the other hand. Which do you think?
Listen, Guy, would you think we could leave this for a day or two longer? I want to rather more pressing matters if you...
Yes, of course.
Excuse me for a moment.
Sorry.
Duffin, we come to you as a deputation. We've been sitting backstage in that ghastly, smelly little kitchen for the best part of 2 weeks.
All right, don't you start.
We're not being unreasonable, David. All we want to know is, will you be needing us this evening or will you not? If not, fair enough, but only some of us have nice, comfy homes we would prefer to be in.
Well, then go on. Go on! Go on to your nice, comfy little houses. Go on! Bugger off, the lot of you!
Well, I am certainly not staying here after that. Not to listen to language like that.
Goodbye!
And furthermore, I shall be having a word with the committee about this whole business. Do you realise that Mr. Washbrook is in tears out there?
So am I!
Are you coming, Faye? Well, there's no point in staying here, is there? Are you coming for a drink?
Oh, probably in a minute.
Good. I'll see you over there.
Oh, Linda, is your Christian around? Where?
I don't know where he is. Why should I know?
Well, have you seen him?
No, I have not seen him, and I have no wish to see him, thank you very much. I should ask her.
Oh, God. Do you know where he is?
Well, I left him, probably.
Where's that?
Asleep. In my bed.
Oh, good night, Ted. Enid, have a lovely evening. Would you enjoy the dinner? Oh, God.
phone for you backstage. Dr. Packer says it's urgent.
More problems.
Right, after that exhausting night's work, now I feel like some refreshment. Are you coming?
Oh, I just want to run my line a couple of times. I've got one or two ideas I want to try.
Well, don't get stale, will you? We've got 2 months to go yet.
Now, I say, do you think this is too obvious, cooking a jacket?
You can't be too obvious with that. Did you see his sound of music?
No.
He had them all on trampolines.
Yes.
Bloody hell's alive, I can tell you. And so were the front stalls. You see, once they got their costumes on, they couldn't control the bounce. Screaming nuns crashing down on the punters. 3 broken legs. 1 concussed from the spot bar, probably still up there for all we know.
Yes, I think I've tried without pink and solid.
By the way, we'd like to invite you over to our place sometime.
Oh, that would be very nice, thank you very much.
I understand you're not married anymore.
No, my wife is ill some
fun. Yes. I dare say you have a friend you could bring?
Oh, yes, I probably could find a friend, yes.
Female, of course.
Of course, don't want to spoil your numbers.
No. The point is, Faye and I, we've probably gathered she's pretty gregarious.
Yeah.
Likes to meet new people all the time. Frankly, so do I. So it all tends to work out in the end, if you follow.
Linda, when are you thinking?
Is Friday night okay for you?
Friday's fine, yes.
Good, we're a little bit of fun, eh?
Splendid.
You might forget your fender.
No, I won't.
Oh, by the way, I'd like to speak to you about your job sometime. I'm very interested in that.
Really? Find such another set of practical philosophers, who to a man are above the fear of death. Ha ha ho. Ha ha ho. Ha ha. Ha ha.
I am a noo. That's what I like to see. A man practicing his craft. I've got a very interesting story about that, will interest you?
Oh, really?
When I was first starting at firm as an apprentice, like, no matter how a boss's son, I had to start on shop floor. Well, first day there, the foreman come up to me, big fella he was, and he says to me, sweep that floor spotless, lad, spotless. I want to eat me dinner off that floor, all right. And I sort of half-swept, you know, like you might. When he come back, he said to me, well, what's this, lad? And he bends down, and he finds a handful of sawdust I've missed under the bench light. And he says, you don't expect me to eat me dinner off that floor, do you? He said, I'd like to see you try it, my lad, he said. And he makes me sit down and he fetches gummy bowl and spoon off rack. And he made me eat that sawdust, just as it was, every scrap that hit it. Aye, nothing on it, no milk, no sugar. Raw sawdust. Aye, and it was the same like that for 3 months. No matter how much boss's son, those lads up shop floor, they taught me the hard way with mouthfuls of sawdust.
Is that right?
Aye, but a little while after that, my dad had his stroke and I took over. I went down in that shop, first thing I did, and I sacked every bloody one of them. Oh, but they taught me trade. I was grateful for that.
Jolly good.
So, just keep at it, lad. Practice your gestures. They all like gestures, you know.
Yes, I will. Thank you.
And another thing. Don't use that fancy accent for it. Use your natural accent. That's what I do. After all, he could have been a Scotty, couldn't he? A Scotty?
Yes, sure.
So, stick up with the sin, lad. Stick up with the sin. Folks will not think less of you for it.
Oh, yes. Thank you. Where should we find such another wee sort of practical philosopher, Jimmy? Who to a man that about the fear of thee? Ooh, hi.
I brought you some tea. Oh,
thank you very much.
Daffy's on the phone. Another crisis, I think.
Oh, well.
You weren't thinking of playing him like that, were you, with that funny accent?
No, that was just an experiment.
Oh, good. I thought you nearly had it right yesterday with the limp, the slight one.
Right, no, I'll try that. I just think it's waiting all this time to rehearse it. It makes one anxious.
Yes, he'll get to you eventually.
I'm sure.
God knows when. I was wondering if you'd mind awfully hearing my lines again.
Oh, no, go. Where would you like to sing?
Just from the top of the page.
Okay.
And are you as fond as ever, my dear?
Suspect my honour, my courage. Suspect anything but my love. May my pistols misfire, and may my mare slip her shoulder while I am pursued, if I ever forsake thee.
Nay, my dear, I have no reason to doubt you, for I find in the romance you lent me, none of the great heroes was ever false in love. Ooh, problems?
One or two. Dr. Packer has just phoned to inform me that faces his with the alternative of either reorganising the new hospital rosters entirely or relinquishing his role as a matter that he has reluctantly decided upon the latter course of action. So there you are, once again, as my father would put it, we are beaten by a bounce.
What's he going to do? Oh,
how the hell should I know?
Guy.
What?
Guy.
Guy?
Yes.
You think so?
Of course.
Guy?
Yes.
You ought to be cast in the role of saviour. What do you say? Matter of the myth, could you do it?
Oh,
I mean, for me, for his own.
I'll go, yes.
Oh, good man, good man.
Super.
Splendid. Well, what do you say? A drink to celebrate?
Why not?
I'll get the lid, but tomorrow, remember, we work.
David.
Yes?
What about Crookfinger Jack?
Well, what about him?
Well, I've only just learned him.
Forget Crookfinger Jack. Boy, you're Matt of the Mint. You're a star now. Well, nearly.
I'm so thrilled for you. Well done.
property. So, you're the first.
Yes, it looks like it, yes.
I'm all right then, anyway.
Yes.
I've got you.
Oh. Well, then I suppose I'm all right as well then, aren't I?
Very true, yes.
Oh, then nice pictures.
We find them quite stimulating.
She's going to bend that one up there, isn't she?
Yes. What about him behind you then?
Good heavens.
We have to take them down when your mother comes to stay.
Yes, I can see she's probably...
Wait and see what we've got in the bedroom.
Yes, wow. You look very nice.
Thank you. So do you.
Thank you.
Do you want to take that off?
No, it's quite all right.
I love men in ties.
Do you? Oh, but you'd like an office then, it's one of them.
Look, I might as well say this early on, then we can relax and enjoy ourselves. If there's anything you particularly like or positively dislike, you will say, won't you?
Oh, I'm not at all fussy. Never have been. I take just what's put in front of me.
I mean, as far as I'm concerned, don't worry. I'm very easy. I don't think there's anything at all. Well, I suppose if it was excessively cruel or painful, I would draw the line.
You mean like you feel with? Yes, you know, feel.
No, I don't think I've tried that.
Sure.
yes, I've been admiring them. Fascinating.
They can do that, you know.
Can you really? Incredible.
One of the few women I know who can. You must get to show you sometime. Look, before we start potting up and getting out of hand, I'd like to just clear up this little business matter with you.
Oh, yes, of course.
Look, I won't beat about the bush. My partner and I have this little building firm, Tommy Hoe. We're contemplating buying a small piece of land which, as it happens, adjoins your factory. You know the place?
Yes, I know.
Ah, good. Well, there is this rumour, isn't there always, that BLM is intending developing the existing premises, in which case the land in question would become a lot more expensive. Do you follow?
Yes.
All I'm asking is the rumour true?
I don't really know, but all I can tell you is what I told Dad. I don't know, but I...
Dad?
Yes, I presume he's acting on your behalf.
Don't take this the wrong way, but I think I could make it worth your while. I think I speak for Faye and say we are both good. Ah, that'll be your rhythm. Doorbell, dog! The sort that likes to keep you waiting, isn't she?
Oh, not if she can help it. I hope she hasn't fallen over.
Fallen over? What is she, on skates? Where is she then?
You have to answer it.
Why?
Your crony incompetence every day. Can I take it you'll agree?
I have a go, yes.
Good.
And thank you.
she suggested you straight away. Of course, I agree. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to run the dance, please, so just take your places. But just before we do, unfortunately, I have to announce yet another cast change. Unwillingly, Ian Hubbard has had to withdraw from his featured role as Filch, and that part will now be taken by our all-purpose replacement, Mr. Guy Jones.
I said he should have played it in the first place.
There is, however, no truth in the rumour that at his present rate of progress he will shortly be taking over from yours truly. Yes, sir. Thank you, Miss Ames.
I've got them on, actually. all right. I'm not stopping.
Good.
I just wanted to give something to Guy.
What?
Here.
What is it?
It's private.
What? Mind your own business. I demand to know what it is. I demand to know. Get your hands off.
Now, head girls, please.
Then tell her to let go. I refuse to allow her to walk in here and start giving you things.
Hannah. No secrets, all right? Anna.
All right, I want to see.
Faye?
Fine with me.
All right, okay, let's see what we have in here. Bloody hell.
They were under the bed. I didn't want you to catch cold.
Total bitch! You total and utter grubby, smutty, grimy, unhygienic little bitch!
Anna!
To you.
Oh, yes, they do.
Nonsense.
I think they do, actually, Faye.
They're hers.
Yes.
Darling, I'm terribly sorry.
When I say they're hers, I actually mean they...
Anna, darling, whoever would have guessed? It just goes to show, behind the most boring exterior...
How dare you do this? How dare you do this?
Look, the weirdest of hang-ups.
Faye, please.
Crushed and shaved.
Sorry we're running a bit late. We'll be with you in a second.
Okay.
Bloody hard work it is with these three. This lad's great voice, but moves like something out of Austin Reed's window. And as for this prissy little madam, look at her. I've seen rough and trade on a health food counter.
Art thou then married, monster?
Art thou then married to another?
Art thou then married to another? Hast thou?
Hast thou two wives, monster?
All right, I know it.
Yes, well, I knew it. I knew it, didn't I?
All right, girls, come on, get on with it now.
Every time I pause for a breath, she reads out my line. Would you kindly ask her not to, please?
Bridget, don't give her a line unless she asks for it. And Linda, you stop pausing for so much breath.
I have to breathe, don't I?
Not necessarily.
You can't say that to a breathing on stage. You want to breathe deeply, you breathe off stage in your own time. Come on, let's get on, and Bridget, shut up.
What's all that? Was the only reason I was here? I mean, what point is there for my sitting here 3 months giving out...
Bridget, shut up! Go on!
Oh, it's my go, is it? Right. If women stand against these for an answer, hear me.
Oh, God.
I heard that.
I won't. Flesh and blood can't bear my usage.
Shall I not claim my own? Sure, my dear, there ought to be some preference shown to a wife. At least she may claim the appearance of it. He must be distracted with his misfortune, or he could not use me thus. Well, what is it then?
Miss Ames?
my nose for a few weeks now.
Oh, come on, boy, be your age. I mean, look, I'm a middle aged man. You know what? That wouldn't be right. Now, let's be reasonable. Don't you try it. I'm a solicitor, you know, and I can have you for, well, I won't, of course. I mean, not if you don't, well, yes.
How about this for starters?
Oh! Oi!
No, not as good as the last one.
Yes, I think he's been hit in the,
It's painful,
Harrison. Well, of course it's pretty painful! Cold water helps, I think.
Sit with Linda. You can use the sink after
her. Oh, well.
Here. Listen to that and tell me what you think it is.
Oh, what is it?
You give up. That's an actual recording of an 1812 Bolton and Watt beam engine, which is still in use to this day, pumping water to the summit of Kennington Avon Canal.
Good heavens.
Aye. It lifts 1 ton of water 40 feet with each stroke of engine.
Amazing.
That's what I've been listening to for the past hour.
Beam engine.
What? No, it's called Vanishing Sounds in Britain. It's put out by BBC. All Vanishing Sounds.
Listening to that, it's probably a good thing, isn't it?
No. I gave it to wife for Christmas, but she doesn't seem to be too keen.
Look, may I have a quick word with you about a piece of the land that apparently belongs to you round the back of the BLM factory, do you know?
No, I own it.
Yes.
No, I'll tell you a very interesting story about that piece of land.
Oh, really?
And that piece of land was bought by my grandfather, old Joshua Pike, for the benefit of his employees. He were a philanthropist. And a deeply religious man, chapel, you know. But his other passion, apart from firm, was cricket. Cricket mad he was. Do you follow?
Yes.
Anyway, he bought that piece of land and he had his lads, his workers, levelling and draining and re-turfing it on their own time, mind, not on his. And when they were finished, he said, "There you are, lads, go to it. That's my gift to you."
Wonderful.
Only thing, being he was religious, not on Sundays, never on Sabbath, lads. Any road up. About a year or so later, he went out one Sunday afternoon for a stroll, taking the air, you know, like you might. And what did he spy as he passed cricket fish? But a bunch of workers laughing and joking and chucking ball about like it was Saturday dinner time. But the old man said, "Nah, not then." The next day, Monday morning, first thing, he had his bulldozers down there and he ripped that piece of land up from one end to the other. He burnt down pavilion and there hasn't been a ball chucked on that piece of land from that day to this. Now, that's the kind of man he was, my granddad. Dying breed.
Yes, another vanishing sound of Britain, eh?
What?
The point is, with regard to this land, there is a rumour, unconfirmed, I may add, that BLM are contemplating buying it, possibly. In which case, it would be worth quite a bit if you were considering selling it. So,
say no more.
You follow me?
Aye. I'm glad of the information. I trust you. You're a Scottie. And I'll see you looked after.
No, I don't need looking after.
Well, what did you tell me for then?
Well, I thought you ought to know. I just didn't want someone to pull the boss on you. Friendly.
Oh, friendly. Aye, that's a good one.
Well, you don't believe me.
Hey, don't come the friendly with me, friend. I've a few years to go on this earth yet, but when I leave it, I'll leave it fair and square, like me dad and me granddad before him. I owe nothing to nobody. They're all paid off. I'll get no call on me from any quarter. I'll not start making exceptions with you. You see me right, I'll see you right. Right?
Right.
Right.
Hello.
Hi.
Good evening.
Has Daddy got to us yet?
No, I'm afraid he hasn't got to very much, actually.
Oh, unsurprising. Where is he? Back there?
Yes.
Right, I'll sort him out then. I've had enough of this.
She's paid off at all. My mother's 92 and she's paid off.
You paid your mother off?
Oh, what? 100 quid a week, tax-free, and a bowl of infant, and she's not complaining. Aye, you'll be paid off too, don't you worry.
Come here, little Filch. Where was your post last night, my boy? I applied at the opera, madam, and considering it was neither dark nor rainy, no great hurry in getting chairs and coaches, made it tolerable on these 7 handkerchiefs, madam. How are you feeling?
Oh, pretty good. Like a man who's just spent his wedding night with an electrified machine shovel. Well, Now we really are in a hole. That boy doesn't come back with over the dead boar line, I can tell you. Trying to do the beggar's opera with Adam McKeith is a bit of a non-starter, even for Peter Brook. Oh, it makes you want to. Oh, but who cares anyway? Who cares?
I do.
Guy, my rock. But nobody really cares. Not in this country. Anything you want to mention is more important than theatre to water them. Washing their hair, cleaning their cars. Why, if this was Bulgaria or somewhere, we'd have peasants hammering on the doors, demanding satisfaction on their money back. This place, you tell them you're interested in the arts, and you get messages of sympathy. Get well soon. Well, maybe they're right. Why beat your brains out? It's just a play, for God's sake, and yet every time he gets like this, desperate, life and death stuff. Well, all that's happened, in fact, is that a play might not happen, that's all. But of course, the irony is that beyond these four walls, in the real world out there, I'm in serious trouble, and I couldn't give a stuff. Now, that really does raise questions, doesn't it? If I were my psychiatrist, I'd be worried that all was not well. And I'd be right.
Any particular sort of trouble?
Well, apart from being beaten up by a singing yahoo, nothing very original. Oh, I don't know, things, Hannah, things like that. She's a bloody deep freezer woman, that's a trouble. Physic, I mean, she's great in other ways. Wonderful at keeping the old going and things. Why, without her? I call her my Swiss Army wife, you know. No man should be without her. It's just that she's got a blade missing, if you know what I mean. Always has. Not her fault, of course, it's just not in her nature. Right from our wedding night. Ice tongues to the third nighty, I tell you.
You didn't find out before you were married?
Well, not from my part of Wales, boy. Not too hot on seeing the return there, you know. It's just that I believe she'd fall. Give him a little warmth and, you know, general encouragement. God, it's not that I didn't try. I really wanted to make it work. I really, really did. I mean, the night I spent battering at those damn defences of hers, but nothing. Knock one down and she'd build another.
Well, you did manage to have twins.
Yes, well, we never talk about that, never.
Ah.
Sorry, bloody poor boy. Shall I bore you with me and Anna? Sorry, I guess it takes a kick in the crotch to make a man painfully aware of his own mortality. Yes?
I'm sorry to interrupt, but first I thought you'd like to know that the loudspeaker in the dressing room is on.
God!
Husbands to bear, but two at a time there's no
This in the post this morning.
Oh, how gorgeous! What is it? I'm sorry, I hate my glasses.
It's £500.
Super.
In notes, cash.
Lucky you. What happened? Someone passed away?
No, not as far as I know. No, I thought it came from you.
Me?
Well, rather than Jarvis.
Jarvis?
Well, I'm pretty certain it's from him.
I think that's highly unlikely. After all, you'd be the first person to get money out of Jarvis.
I'm really certain it is from him.
I don't think so. Why should my husband give you £500?
Because I warned him about this rumour. I can't agree to find any truth or foundation.
I heard the rumour.
You have?
Oh, yes.
Well, the point is, I didn't want him to be taken advantage of. Or you.
I'm coming up.
Can somebody please open some doors? It's so tropical in here.
Oh,
ridiculous time to say this, I know.
Oh, thank you, thank you. I'm going to have to take this frost out of here, Raymond. I hate it passionately. I'm sorry, I can't live with the frost up here. Sorry, Guy, look, you're going to be sensational, no doubt. I mean, just do what you've been doing in rehearsal. The audience are going to lift your game anyway. You're home and dry.
It's not the show I'm talking about, Deppard.
Just hang up to this. I just want to steady something. Guitar. Now's your chance to get your own back. Tip me off if you want.
I don't want to do that, Deppard.
All I can say is it's a good job it's you down there. There's a whole committee of them back there. We'll do it with pleasure.
Hey, is this right?
That's great, Jarvis. Knockout.
Not the right trousers, of course.
No, obviously.
Nor do they appear to be any boots. The girl's looking.
Oh dear. I don't know.
I particularly wanted boots. I asked for boots. I mean, the man's in jail, he would have boots, wouldn't he? Wait. He won't wear his shoes, not in a jail.
Don't worry, Jarvis, we'll find you some boots, don't worry.
Well, I'm not playing him in shoes, I'll tell you that. I mustn't find myself some boots.
It would help if he found his bloody line trick, you can't. Finish with the ladders! Walk! Look at that, eh? Oh, what time's this, then? What time's this?
I'm not on until later, am I?
Oh, fair enough.
You seen the paper, then?
No, I haven't really had time.
All over the front page. There you have it. Closure shock. BLM closing.
What's that?
BLM closing down.
Closing down?
That's what it says. 500 jobs gone.
Bloody hell.
They're relocating 130.
128, exactly.
Oh, so you did know that?
Oh, yes.
I bet you bloody do. Don't miss a trick, do you?
How long have you known this?
Well, since I found a note on my desk this morning. Along with the rest of us. It's true.
I believe you, Sunshine. I believe you.
It is true.
Sure.
Well, if it makes you happy, I don't happen to be true from the 128.
That's hardly surprising, is it? Is this all right, Dapper? Seeing as I'm bound to be standing behind some huge tree or something, it probably doesn't matter anyway.
Oh, that's super, Becky, super.
You actually like it?
That's just right.
Well, it's your production, darling. If you're expecting laughs, you won't be disappointed, will you? He likes it. I told you he would.
Come on, let's get this show on the road. How are you doing, Raymond, dare I ask? I requested these ladders be moved. Why haven't they? Bridget, somebody, please. I'm desperately sorry to hear about this guy. I really am. Is that what you wanted to tell me just now? God damn sorry. Just like I said, isn't it? Here we all are playing around with pretty lights and costumes altogether with safety pins, but out there it's all happening. You'll be okay. I know you will. Don't despair, old friend. Excuse me, I'm going to have to light a few fireworks back there. Total and utter bastard, and my one prayer is that one of these days you'll get one.
what's coming to you, okay? That's all I've got to say to you. Having said all that, all the very best of luck for the show. And I hope it goes really well for you. Good luck. Right, everyone, let's get this show on the road. Lights and music!
My dear Lucy, my dear Polly, whatsoever has passed between us is now at an end. If you are fond of marrying again, the best advice I can give you is to ship yourselves off to the West Indies, where you shall have a fair chance of finding a husband at least. Oh, by good luck to all three as you like there.
Four more women, Captain. Look here, there's one.
What? Four wives more? This is too much. Here, tell the sheriff's officers I am ready.
How can I bear this sight?
There is nothing that moves one so much as a great man in distress.
Thank you.
an uncle of disapproval. Mm.
Yeah. I tremble, I droop.
No token of love.
See my courage at home.
No token of love.
Thank you.
I don't. I drink, of course, as well. Lots.
Backstage, I'm the DJ, so what, I mean, what else can I say?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
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 Y
Sweet of you. Of course, man, there goes Mac the Knife.